right, let's start with this. Today is a new day for gaming. Lotto operations have already been lifted. The suspension's been lifted. But all other gaming operations remain suspended. So we have STL suspended pa yun, Kino suspended, and Periangan ng Bayan is suspended. How will this affect the government's programs?
Well, definitely it will affect the revenue collections of the government's program, especially for those mandatory contributions mandated by the PCSO. I think there are 11 to 13 laws that mandates PCSO to support and augment funding of different agencies of the government.
No.
Among these are Philippine Sports Commission and Commission on Higher Education. And so we really have to determine and exact the level of the shortfall of revenues. Mm-hmm. And we need the opinion of the Department of Finance. But we are thankful to the President that he already lifted the suspension on Lotto, because mm-hmm. Lotto is the, I think this is the front runner in contributing to the income of the PCSO. Second is the STL mm-hmm. and Kino. Mm-hmm. So malaki pa rin, substantial pa rin yung mawawala.
Okay, would you have the numbers in terms of CHED, which would be very important? How much has PCSO been giving CHED every year?
Well, the mandatory contributions provided for under the law is 1% of the gross sales that goes to CHED. Mm-mm. So hindi ko lang alam kung magkano, it depends on the collections of the PCSO. Pero malaki po yun.
Pero with Lotto, now that the ban's been lifted, would it still have a dramatic effect? I mean, right now, STL operators, they claim there are 12 STL operators. The government claims they failed to remit 5 billion to PCSO for a period of a few years, which means even with the so-called failed remittance, PCSO is still able to fund CHED maybe, and the Philippine Sports Commission maybe coming from Lotto mostly.
Well, Lotto comprised 50% of the total income of PCSO. In 2018, the COA report stated that out of the 63 billion income, 31 billion comes from Lotto. Mm-hmm. And 26 from STL, 4 billion from Kino, and instant sweepstakes, I think, mm-hmm. is 1 billion. So all in all, that's 63 billion pesos. So malaki pa rin. When it comes to STL remittance, doon talaga nagkakaproblema. You said that there were 5 billion pesos?
I think in failed remittance. Yeah,
failed
that's
remittance.
The report. Coming
kasi
from
naman,
12 STL operators.
Eh kasi naman, yung STL, ginagawang front ng weteng. Yun ang nagiging problema dito. And base sa ating mga reports, yung STL operators, yun din yung nagbubukis. Yun din yung nagpapatakbo mm-hmm. ng weteng. And that's why, yung remittance sa PCSO and the shares of the local government units hosting, they said, betting games, nasa short change. Uh-oh.
So pag kayong tatanungin, Congressman, mas mabuti bang illegalize na lang ang weteng? Kumbaga, iba-iba na lang ang singilin na taxes. Pero in the end, just keep it all out in the open because it still exists.
Well, STL is legalized form of wetting. Mm-hmm. Ang nagkakaproblema lang, sino-shortchange yung ating gobyerno sa pag-remit ng share ng sa PCSO at sa local government units.
Kasi may street wetting eh.
At napupunta doon sa politiko, sa pulis. Yun naman ang ano dyan eh. Kung hindi inaalaw ng kapulisan at ng chief executives of the local government units, walang mangyayaring wetting.
So in other words, there's no need to legalize wetting because STL is legalized wetting. They need to enforce.
They need to enforce the law. They need to strictly enforce and implement the conditions of the licenses pertaining to the operations of STL. Mm-hmm. And that is what the president exactly want to address.
There's also, what can you say first with the president lifting the suspension on Lotto operations? It happened just last night.
Well, nagpapasalamat tayo dahil nakita niya na yung problema hindi naman masyado sa Lotto. Doon ito sa STL. STL can even surpass the collection and income contribution to PCSO if the loss the licenses and the conditions component to the said license and franchise mm-hmm. will be strictly complied with.
Oo.
Mas marami pang makokolekta.
Now, Congressman, there's a suggestion that perhaps it would be best to privatize all gaming activities and let the PCSO just serve as a collection agency of some kind. Kumbaga, ang trabaho na lang niya, mangolekta, pero pribadong sektor na ang nagpapatakbo ng gaming. Would that be efficient for you?
It is efficient if you will look at in some jurisdictions, in some countries, mm-hmm. talagang privatized.
Like the U.S.
Like the U.S. and in some other countries, in ASEAN countries. Dito sa ating bansa, if you will look at the trajectory of the collections, say in 2017, umangat in 2016, umangat 2018, umangat ng almost 65% ang collection.
Mm-hmm.
From 17 billion to 26 billion pesos STL collection.
Yeah.
Pag in-enforce lang yung collection,
yeah.
if there is an efficient and effective collection in the PCSO share and local government share,
mm-hmm.
hindi mo kailangan i-privatize.
Uh-oh. So what do you think should be given to the PCSO to be able to enforce collection in a more powerful manner, especially with STL operators? Diba? Because, you know, Lotto, they're running it, that's easy. But STL operators, you're also confronted with businessmen who are exposed to gambling. It's a whole other world with STL.
This is a convergence effort of the law enforcement, the local government officials, and at the same time, the officials of the PCSO. Ang sinasabi na ating presidente dito, merong connivance eh. Lahat nag-connive para maipacket nila mm-hmm. yung dapat na remittance sa PCSO na pupunta sa bulsa
mm-hmm.
ng nandiyan yung law enforcement, nandiyan yung top officials of the PCSO, and at the same time, local government, the chief mm-hmm. executives of the local government.
Oo. Okay. Now, you want PAGCOR to actually help CHED and the Philippine Sports Commission. You filed House Resolution Number 147. Do you still want to continue this even after Lotto is open?
Yes, Karen. As I've said, Lotto is only 50% of the total income of PCSO. The other half,
only mandated to give 1% to CHED.
Yes.
Maliit yun.
And the other half is those collections coming from STL, Kino, and other betting games that are still
mm-hmm.
suspended. And so, definitely, there will be a shortfall in the revenue collections. And we have to exact the level of the financial support to PSC and CHED, mm-hmm. considering that PSC, ayaw natin ma-hamper yung training ng ating mga atleta.
To think it's not funded enough.
Yes.
Oo.
Pangalawa, mag-host tayo ng Southeast Asian Games. So, ayaw natin magkaroon ng aberya. And sa CHED naman, we want to consider the the collegiate year had already started since June.
Mm-mm.
So, paano yung operasyon at yung pag-aaral ng ating mga kabataan, especially the research. So, yun yung ating ina-address dito.
So, how much, based on your House resolution, do you believe should PAGCOR give? I mean, in the last State of the Nation address of President Duterte, he congratulated PAGCOR for being now it's one of the top three cash cows of government. And I think 3 weeks ago, the president, it had turned over 16.7 billion pesos to the government coffers after BIR and Customs. So how much do you believe should PAGCOR give CHED and the Philippine Sports Commission?
I don't have the exact figure, Karen. I want to call on the Department of Finance together with the Philippine Sports Commission and CHED for them to talk about it and exact the level of the financial support that is needed to augment the funding of the two agencies.
Mm-mm.
Dapat mag-usap-usap.
Uh-oh. I mean, clearly the bigger picture is a lot of government projects are funded by gambling revenues. Is there any way that the government can just at least earn more, given that gambling is allowed, legal, supported in the country.
Well, that's the reality.
Kasi you also have big hotels that have, you know, high profile and high stake gamblers. Are we collecting enough from them?
I hope so, Karen. Sana napipinpoint din yun. But you know, really the financial assistance, the subsidy, and of course the charitable works, most of which are coming from gambling money.
Mm-mm.
And I, as I have said earlier, there are 13 laws that says that PCSO and PAGCOR are really mandated to augment and contribute to the funding of different agencies. Among others is the Philippine Sports Commission, the CHED. Of course, recently is the Universal Healthcare Program, where we needed at least 257 billion pesos to, you know, operationalize the said law.
Now, as it is, apparently, lotto sales are down by 30%. Kumbaga, paunti ng paunti na ang tumataya sa lotto. If it's down by 30%, what is the long-term solution you're seeing if CHED and PCSO need money from lotto?
Well, we need to.
So you want PAGCOR?
PAGCOR. Oo. And, you know, PAGCOR, aside from their mandatory contributions, in totality, yung natira nilang pondo, it is remitted to the president's as social fund.
I see.
Pwede rin kunin doon. Billion-billion rin
yun. I'm curious, would you have the division, let's say, of the 16.7 billion of PAGCOR, how much of the pie goes to the president's fund?
Ganito yon. Yung 5% goes to the franchise tax, and the 50% of the 95% remaining goes to the subsidies.
Mm-mm.
And
pero walang CHED and PSC doon.
Nandun na yung mga mandatory contributions.
Sa PAGCOR to, ha?
Sa PAGCOR. And the remaining income is remitted to the Office of the President for President's Social Fund.
So technically, what you want, the story today should be you want less money to be remitted to the President's Social Fund and more of the pie to go to CHED and PSC directly or these agencies.
No, the premise of my resolution is not to confer power to the President, but to urge the President to exercise his power of control and supervision over all executive offices such as PAGCOR and PCSO. Kung may kakulangan dito sa PCSO, sa kanyang mandatory contributions,
but
kumuha doon sa PAGCOR.
That would be very discretionary. It would depend on who the president is. In other words, if you end up with a president na ayaw niya, I like my social fund on my own, nothing would happen. It would affect programs. So ang tanong ko, for PAGCOR to increase donations to these agencies, do you need congressional approval for this? Or is the president's discretion enough?
It is, you know, emanates from the president's power of control and supervision over all executive departments, under which kasama na dyan, it speaks of executive departments, bureaus and offices, kasama dyan yung PAGCOR and PCSO.
So you don't need the House itself, your resolution, the resolution you filed, if the President agrees, that's enough?
Yes.
Or you would also need Senate concurrence?
No.
No more?
No. What we're showing is this is the sense of the House of Representatives for the President to exercise that power.
Do you believe you'd have the support of the majority on this?
Yeah, when you speak of education, sports budget, that's no brains. Sasama yan. Na talaga naman na susuportahan nila.
Okay. Now, speaking of Congress, you believing you'd have the support of the majority, the minority has already, I wanted to ask you,
constituted.
Yes, how you formed so far. You have Benny Abante as your new minority leader. And I think, did you say 20, you have 27 already?
28.
28 members already. You met over the weekend.
No, wait.
Is that correct?
After we elect the speaker, the rule says that the minority must constitute and elect from among themselves their minority leader. So the day after the inaugural session, when we elect the speaker, we elected our minority leader. And those who elected the minority leader were those who did not vote for the winning speaker.
Yeah.
Kasama ako doon.
Oo. But have you met already with those wanting to join the minority?
We already convened. Those who abstained, did not vote for the winning speaker, we invited them so that they will be part of the constituting the minority.
Uh-oh. And so I wanted to ask you, because Congressman Lito Atienza abstained, am I correct?
Yes.
So does that means he's part of your minority already?
At the first instance, he was part of the minority. In fact, he was part of electing Benny Abante. And then this week, he wrote a letter addressed to the minority leader and to the deputy, or to the majority leader, to the speaker, informing that he intends to be an independent mm-hmm. member of the House of Representatives.
Okay, but then under the rules, because it's happened in the last election of speaker as well, it seems that the rules in the House can be easily bent according to convenience or when convenient. Under the rules, strictly House rules, when you don't vote for the speaker or you abstain, dapat minority ka.
Well, tama ho.
Kailan ka ba nagiging independent?
When you signify that you want to be independent.
Right on the roster, oo.
Yes, when you...
sa podium.
When you signify your intent that I don't want to be part of the minority nor the majority, then you become independent.
But can you do that after that moment of voting? Like what Congressman Lito Atienza did, or ideally, no?
You have to inform
so he did.
The leadership.
Uh-oh.
And so he wrote a letter to the speaker and to the majority.
Now, even in the past, choosing a minority floor leader has always been controversial. Congressman Edsel Lagman said, Abante is the choice of the majority bloc to be minority leader. Ideally, the minority should be someone who's against the majority. But it seems that there's already an agreement between the majority and the minority. Okay, you're the minority. Let's all be happy. Is he the choice of the majority bloc?
Between Kong Edsel's words and the 28 who elected Benny Abante, it is certainly the choice of the minority. Kasama doon yung makabayan group. Kasama yung makabayan group, kasama yung LP, kasama yung party list coalition. So this is really a coalition of those who did not elect Speaker Cayetano and constitute themselves as the minority.
But what are you seeing as the role of the minority in the 18th Congress, the last 3 years of President Duterte? Clearly, you don't want to be destructive. What role are you seeing?
Well, we will be a fiscalizer. We don't want to be destructive. We will support the programs of the president as long as it will benefit and inure to the people. But if it is not beneficial or in contravention with the letters of the Constitution, makakarinigo sila sa amin.
Okay. Now, when it comes to the death penalty, the minority has already signified that it will be against the death penalty, correct?
Tama ho kayo.
However, wasn't the death penalty already passed in the lower house?
In the lower house, but I was consistent with my vote. I voted no in the 17th Congress. And that's why in the 18th Congress, I joined again the minority purposely para panindigan pa rin yung aking voto sa death penalty. Because I believe it is not a deterrent to the commission of a crime. What is really deterrent is the certainty of arrest and prosecution. Yun yung kulang natin. Mm-hmm. Kaya nga yung...
But there's no way to do the vote again because it's already been passed.
No.
Pwede pa.
They have to refile it. Mm. And in fact, it was refiled because...
Sino nag-refile?
In the House, marami po. Supportive of that. The thing is, we have a bicameral Congress that even if it is passed in the House, if it is not supported in the Senate, wala pa rin yun. So it should be actively acted upon by two houses of Congress.
Mm-mm. Okay. Now, Speaker Cayetano promised certain things for the minority. I wanted to ask you, no fund deprivation. It sounds actually funny when you read it. But what does no fund deprivation mean to a minority congressman?
Well,
ano bang nangyayari minsan?
Sa minority kasi, meron ding minority funds. Yung aming allowances.
Mm-mm.
Hindi gusto sabihin na sa minority ka, wala kang allowance.
Do you mean to say there have been speakers in the past that had removed these allowances?
Yes, meron, meron. Merong tinatanggal nila yung MOOE, yung operasyon ng aming mga opisina, district offices as well as provincial offices.
Yeah.
Of course, yung sweldo, hindi nila pwede tanggalin yun. But ngayon, wala talagang funds deprivation when it comes to releasing the MOOE and other you know, entitlements enjoyed by the members of the majority. So, wala talaga.
Okay, that's number one. What about committee vice chairmanships? Let's discuss that. Has it been finalized? I know that vice chairmanships and some major committees were also given to minority congressmen, not as a chairman, but may role.
When we were initially constituting the minority, I talked to Speaker Cayetano. And I conferred to her that sabi ko, Speaker, the last Congress accorded vice chairmanship to the members of the minority. And sabi niya sa akin, huwag ka mong problema dyan, Pido, because if there is a precedent, then I will honor it. And so, some who joined the minority, yun naman talaga yung kanilang konsiderasyon na they will still be given their vice chairmanship wish list dahil commitment naman yun ni Speaker
Why
Cayetano.
Is that important?
Well,
for the minority to be vice, to have their vice chairmanship in major committees.
Aside from the vote, you want to have an active participation in the running of the committee. And so if you are one of the vice chair, like for example in appropriation, franchise.
Pwede mo rin bantayan eh.
Pwede mo bantayan at malaki rin ang yung boses doon. So hindi lang pagiging membro, malaki rin yung participasyon na magiging vice chair.
No, you are vice chair of what committee?
Last Congress, I was deputy minority leader and at the same time member of the House Contingent of the Commission on Appointments. Now, being a deputy minority leader, hindi mo na kailangan mag-vice chair dahil ex-officio member ka na ng lahat ng major as well as special committees.
But you are still deputy minority leader?
Wala pa. Hindi pa ako nai-elect. Eh. Mukhang hindi ako mai-elect ngayon. Dahil sabi nila,
give chance to others.
Yes.
Ganun
and mukhang ilalagay naman po ako sa Commission on Appointments.
And you want that committee?
Opo.
As vice chair.
As vice chair, hiningi ko pa rin yung... Huwag ko na lang sabihin.
Sabihin mo na. Okay lang.
Justice.
Okay, justice.
I was so active in the 17th Congress in the Committee of in the Committee on Justice. And other committees such as Appropriation, Health, of course, Franchise. Uh-oh. Active din ako sa Franchise.
Yeah.
Transportation. One of the advocacy, kaya meron tayo, nilalabanan natin yung provincial bus ban.
Mm-mm.
And natural resources.
Yeah.
Hate.
You can be vice chairman of so many committees? Or
no, only two.
Two. And then the others, you can be a member of as much as you want? How does it work in the House?
Well, or you hanggang can sit kaya mo. Hanggang kaya mo panindigan yung iyong trabaho at responsibility. Because there are, I think, three or four strike rule wherein if you fail to attend for, if I'm not mistaken, three or four consecutive absences in a committee, pwede ka natanggalin ng majority.
I see.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Because sabi nga ni Senator Pia Cayetano, the work is really, di ba, in the committee hearings, eh, and that's the one that's not shown on television all the time. But that's where the work lies. Okay, so just quickly, what about Tourism, Games, Ethics, Public Accounts Committee? The minority has vice chairmanships here.
Yeah, the public accounts is reserved for the minority. Ethics is also reserved for the minority. And so the chairmanship will belong to the minority.
Ah, really? Chairman to? So sino?
In the previous Congress, 17th Congress, si Cong Delfli yung nag-chair ng Committee on Ethics. And the public accounts was chaired by the minority leader, Danny Suarez.
Okay. Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.
Thank you.